Smitherman here to tell you about Sierra Instruments Insertion Retractor. This is our newly designed retractor, compact and ergonomic. It's accessible from both the top and bottom with any tool that has a quarter inch ratcheting feature. So just a hand ratchet, power drill with a quarter inch ratchet adapter. They make several tools. All right. So always remember to read and follow any and all safety requirements that your factory has set, as well as any safety standards that might come with the application that you're tapping into. So we're here today on a 6-inch Schedule 40 pipe, water coming through here. Okay, so this would be a typical hot tap installation. This weldolet's been welded into the pipe. We added a 2-inch flanged adapter. This is a 2-inch isolation ball valve, and then we have our 241i insertion meter with a packing gland, 2-inch flange packing gland adapter. Got a big wrench to actuate the valve. This is just a hand power tool with a quarter-inch ratchet adapter. Most important tool for installation is just a 5/16-inch hex driver, which I'll use to install the mounting brackets. So the retractor is secured to the process connection and probe with these two brackets. Each one is uniquely machined so that it'll only fit in one way. So I've already just hand tightened the top bracket here. I'm gonna install the bottom one. It has the same shelf that fits into the process connection like so. And it's important to leave the top loose for now because I'm gonna have to index it in a second. So unlike some retractors on the market, we've gone with a sleek, kind of compact design. You can orient it any way you want. I'd just like to show you that our retractor has 180 degrees rotation. All right, so before I finish securing the bracket, the last thing I need to do is get this bracket indexed properly by moving it up until it butts up against the flow pointer right here. So I'm just gonna get it from right here, and I'm just gonna slowly move it up until it hits the flow pointer like so. All right, so my top bracket is pressed all the way up against the flow pointer. I'm now just gonna tighten it down and then we are ready. So it was a little tight for my hand drill between the actuator for the valve. So I'm just gonna move this over a tiny bit so I have better access to it. All right, so real quick, I'm gonna kind of give you guys a visual on how the probe is oriented right now and kind of what's gonna happen. So right now the probe, if you can imagine, it's sitting kind of somewhere between the two flanges and the ball valve here. And I've actually already taken the time to mark actually where that point is on the meter. So I know that when this top bracket is up to this point right here, that the unit is up above the ball valve. I can close the ball valve and then pull it out. When I actuate it down to the proper insertion depth, it's gonna lower the probe down into the center of the pipe like that. And I've actually already marked that too, which is right here. And it'll look something like that. How do I know how far down to insert the probe to ensure that the sensor head is in the center of my pipe? I'm here at Sierra University. I'm going to walk you through the formula we use to figure out our insertion depth. So over here, I've drawn a diagram. We've got a cross section of pipe, a weldolet, a flange weldolet, and a 2-inch isolation valve. Just drawn kind of cross section. This is our process connector and the probe itself. So insertion, or value I, is what we're trying to get. S is our stem length of the probe, which is the length from the pointer to the center of the head of the probe down here. On a standard length probe, that's going to be 32 inches. Next is F, which is the length from of your process connection. In this case, it's a welded flange weldolet and an isolation valve. F is 12 inches. So if I subtract those, pretty easy, 20 inches. All right. So next is R, which is the radius of the pipe. So over here, I have some information about our pipe downstairs. We're using 6-inch Schedule 40 pipe. I just took this off a standard pipe schedule table. The OD, the wall thickness, and the ID. R is the radius of the pipe, so all we need to do is take the ID and divide it by 2. So come over here, our radius is equal to 3.03 inches. Subtract that and we get 16.97 inches. So we're almost finished. The last thing we need to do for our formula is subtract the wall thickness. So T is equal to 0.280. And so subtract that, and we're left with 16.69 inches. And that is what I equals I. That's our insertion depth. It's important to note when inserting into pipes greater than 10 inches that instead of trying to get to the center line of the pipe, we just want to insert 5 inches down. So in those cases, you replace your R value with 5 inches, and that's clearly stated in the manual. All right, so we've calculated our insertion depth, 16.69 inches, and that insertion depth is going to represent the bottom of our packing gland to the bottom of the pointer nut. And you can reference page 22 in the manual to see this kind of diagram that I've drawn right here. But now let me show you how to mark the retractor with this insertion depth and then get the probe to the where it needs to be. Probably, maybe some of you guys have in the field, you've installed some of these and you've bottomed out. I just got a little note, don't bottom out. It's very important. Here I have a mock-up of a probe and retractor to show you how we mark that insertion depth on the retractor. So we've got a probe, process connection, and retractor, and I just have a tape measure. It's important when you're measuring, when you're going to mark the retractor for the insertion depth, to know that the measurement begins at the bottom of whatever your process connection is. So in this case, we've got a flange process connection, so I just start my measurement here. I go up to my number, which is 16.69, and I'm just going to make a little mark there. So I made a small mark, so I'm just going to take one of these post-it notes, just going to put it on my mark. That's going to represent the point where I need to bring this bracket down to. My retractor is oriented in a way that's easy for me to access. My isolation valve is closed. Right now this packing gland is tightened. It's hand tightened. So now my retractor is secured. I've checked my flow pointer to make sure it's in the right direction. I'm ready to insert this probe into the pipe. First step is going to be to open my isolation valve. Open this up. Next, I'm going to loosen the nut on the packing gland here to ensure that the probe can move easily up and down. You want to do this slowly. And now I'm ready to actuate our retractor. So I got my power drill here, quarter inch ratchet adapter. Depending on the pressure of your system, you might have to use a different tool or a more heavy duty tool to actuate it. And I'm gonna slowly lower it, and I'm gonna be watching that top bracket. And when it gets to my green mark there, I'm ready to stop. And I'm in my probe in the middle of the pipe. I lowered it until the top of the bracket is at my mark, which tells me that my probe has been inserted so that the head is in the center of this pipe. I'll check the flow arrow again, make sure it didn't move side to side too much. It looks good. I can tighten my packing gland. So like I said, you can use one retractor for many units. So I'm going to remove this retractor and take it to the next unit. One quick tip, you can use the fire wrap. Just kind of secure that like this, and now I should be able to remove this without worrying about it falling over or anything like that. All right, remove the bracket. I'm gonna clip that off, and I'm ready to go to the next unit. It was really great to show you guys Sierra's new insertion retractor. We're really proud of the compact ergonomic design we've come up with. It works great in tight spaces. I've been on a lot of sites where you don't have a lot of room to work with. This thing's easy to get to and operate. And all it takes is some off-the-shelf tools you can find at any hardware store. So thank you again.